Hello everybody, this is Ashley Verma, an intern with Lexis & Company, and today in this video I will be dealing with a case named Internet Association versus RBI 2020. So the citation of the case is SCC Online SC 275, and this was filed in the Supreme Court of India. The bench consists of Justice Rohinton Fali Anirman, Justice Anuradha Bose, Justice Ram Subramaniam. The date of judgment is 4th March 2020. The headnotes of the case involves Article 19(1)(g) of the Constitution of India, Section 2, 18, 22, 36 Clause 1A, 45 I of the Banking and Regulation Act 1949, and Section 18 of the Payment of Wages Act 1936. So the facts of the case include that this case deals with the prohibition of banking and other entities from trading in virtual currencies via circular issued by RBI on 6th April 2018. Moreover, the circular also barred the bank from providing any service to an individual or entity dealing with the virtual currencies. So the reasoning behind the circular was that they were concerned about the security of transaction and hacking of the virtual currencies, which could lead to various problems in the economy, such as loss of economy, money laundering, promoting terrorist attacks, and many more. So the matter was challenged by the Internet and Mobile Association of India. The Supreme Court allowed the petition on the ground of proportionality. The appellant argued that RBI does not have the legislative power to prohibit the trading of virtual currencies. Besides, it also violates Article 19(1)(g) of the Constitution of India, which gives the right to practice in any profession or to carry any occupation, trade or business. So the issues which are involved in the case are, number one, whether the RBI, that is the Reserve Bank of India, had the jurisdiction to disallow the trade of virtual currency, whether the respondent had the power to regulate virtual currencies as they were not equivalent to money or legal tender. Third, whether the circular which was issued by the RBI was proportional to supposed risk. So these were the three issues that was arisen. So the points in the case include the history and role of RBI after discussing the RBI Act 1934, the Banking Regulation Act 1949, and the Payment and Settlement Act 2007. Observe that RBI is vested with the powers to regulate the monetary framework of the country. Further, the RBI derives its power from RBI Act 1934. And the source from the Banking Regulation Act 1949. Though virtual currencies does not acquire the status of legal tender, it can still be used as real money. RBI can invoke its power irrespective of the fact that if something is a legal tender or has the four characteristics of being an actual currency. So in different jurisdictions, the virtual currency was identified in terms of property, funds, commodities, and money. Therefore, if the property can act as money to some extent, the contention that RBI has no jurisdiction to deal with the same is nullified. The impugnant circular did not prohibit the use or trading of virtual currency altogether. The circular was only limited to the entities regulated by RBI and directed that not to deal or provide services to individual and entity dealing with the virtual currency. At last, regarding the proportionality, RBI could not showcase the injury or losses suffered by the entities. In addition, RBI could have adopted other alternative measures that were less damaging. So these were all the points that was derived from the case. Finally, the judgment by the court. The Honorable Supreme Court, after considering the factual matrix and the contentions of the parties, held that the circular issued by RBI is unenforceable and unlawful on the ground of proportionality. So the court also ordered RBI to direct the Central Bank of India not to freeze the accounts and to repay the price with the interest to the petitioner. Also, the court also held that RBI must produce objectively reliable empirical data to establish the harm suffered by the traditional economy on account of virtual currencies trading in India. RBI failed to show that any of the entity regulated by it have suffered any loss or impact adversely due to virtual currencies exchange. So the Supreme Court held that a complete ban on trading was excessive and disproportionate. The court said that such administrative order should be backed by rationality and cannot be ambiguous. Therefore, the court quashed the RBI circular while ruling that it offended the doctrine of proportionality and was in violation of Article 19, Clause 1G. So this is of the Constitution of India. So this is it. Hope you like it. Thank you so much.